Hello, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to focus on horse psychology according to Ayurveda. I hope this is going to be helpful for you to know your horse better. And I will also give you some tips towards the end, how to help your horse to be more balanced, more happy, more healthy, and cooperative with you. This is Dr. Helena Pokorová, and I'm going to guide you through this topic. I will open my presentation here. Thank you for waiting. So, horse psychology according to Ayurveda. What type is your horse? I'm sure that this is the question that you are most interested in. Okay, what is my horse and how can I treat him in such a way that will help him? Before we get into recognizing the type of your horse, we will learn some basic principles of Ayurveda, which are going to be helpful for us. So according to Ayurveda, everything in this material world is composed of five elements: ether, air, fire, water, and earth. These five elements are the creating elements of everything that is in this material world. The elements together combine into energetic forces and building forces. So earth and ether combined compose vata, which is wind. Fire and water combined compose pitta, which is fire or bile. And water and earth compose kapha, which is mucus. We are going to use a lot these terms, vata, pitta, and kapha. So pay attention to those. And in Ayurveda, this vata, pitta, and kapha and their various combination is a similar concept like DNA in the Western science. So according to how much vata, pitta, and kapha an individual has, it determines the species of life. Just like DNA, various species of life have various DNA, but also within one species, the combination of vata, pitta, and kapha creates the distinctive individual. So just like DNA, the various DNA creates all distinctive characteristics of the one individual. So now we are going to look at the vata, pitta, and kapha types of horses. And the doshas determine prakriti, vikriti, and mind. Today we are focusing on the mind because this is a psychological module, but just to have the concept together, prakriti is the gross material body. That's what we can see. And that's the qualities with which the horse is born with, which means is the body type, the constitution, how easy is the horse going to gain weight, how big his hooves are going to be, how thick his tail and mane are going to be. So that's prakriti, the qualities that we can see, and also the metabolism and the actions, the energy in the body, that we can see by the results, by gaining weight. And it's determined already before the horse is born by the different combination of doshas. Vikriti is the state right now. So the horse is born and there are different influences of the environment that are affecting the doshas. So that's a little different than the DNA. Actually, most modern research also shows that the environment is affecting what parts of the DNA are showing outside. So that's like vikriti. What the doshas are, what's their balance right now? Because maybe I have a budweiser horse, So they are well built, gain weight very easily, they are chubby and steady and grounded, and all that is their Prakriti. And then in their Vikriti, it might be different if the horse is starving, is being treated really harshly and put in a lot of stress environment, then his Vikriti is changing. And then from the like really steady, grounded horse might be a nervous, angry horse who is skinny. So that's Vikriti. And then mind. Mind is a subtle body. It's also in Ayurveda, the mind, intelligence, and false ego are also part of the body, but it's the subtle body, the body that we cannot see. And it's also created by the doshas, by the five elements. And the mind type is affecting especially the behavior and how the horse is going to respond to different stimuli. So we are going to find out now what mind type is your horse. And the procedure will follow that I will show qualities for Vata, for Pitta, and for Kapha. And in each section, you are going to count what qualities fit your horse, and you will make a count how much is it for each section. So for example, at the end, you will have 8 for Vata, 5 for Pitta, and 3 for Kapha. And I'm not going to make the time for you. I trust that you can pause the YouTube video, make your count, and then once you do it for all 3 doshas, we will see each other again. So this is the qualities of Vata horse. These qualities for Pitta horse. And qualities for Kapha horse. So I trust that now you have your count. And don't be discouraged or disappointed if you have 5 for Vata, 5 for Pitta, 5 for Kapha, because these things are dynamic and are changing throughout the life of the horse, throughout daytime, throughout time of a year. We will get into that soon. And so maybe you have a predominance at a certain moment and a different predominance at a different moment. Or maybe you found out that we have 8 for Pitta and 3 for Kapha, 3 for Vata. So you know, okay, I have a Pitta horse. So that's the mind type. There are some dynamic in that. So it's not that the horse is in one type of dosha or all their life. For example, in the morning, there is a predominance of Kapha influence. At noon, Pitta influence. In the evening, more Vata influence. So if I have a horse that's not like completely distinct, then maybe in the morning I have a horse that's more relaxed, and in the evening I have a horse that's more spooky. Also, the seasons of the year, spring Kapha, summer Pitta, fall and winter Vata. So maybe in the summer I have a horse that's lazy, and in fall and winter I have a horse that's so spooky that I'm even afraid to sit on him. There are different influences on the different doshas. Also for pregnancy, there is a first trine Kapha, second trine Pitta, third trine Vata. That's why in the first trine there is common the morning sickness in women, and in the second trine there is common different itchiness and heat in the body. For also throughout the lifetime, the influences of Kapha, Pitta, and Vata are changing. The babies have increase of Kapha, adults Pitta, that's the active time of life, and old age is Vata. So if you are still not quite clear what your horse is, what your mind type is, then also what can be helpful is to look at his bodily construction, the Prakriti. The bodily construction doesn't always correspond with the mind type, and it's quite common that it does correspond. because we breed horses for generations and generations, so they have certain qualities of mind and body. So in humans, the correspondence is not as common as in horses. In horses, the correspondence is very common. So to help you determine their mind type, I will also show some specific examples of each. So Achelteke, this is like a topmost example of a Vata type of horse, very skinny, gentle skin, thin mane, thin tail, thin legs, long legs, very like noble looking, long ears, thin nose. So that's a body type of Vata horse, a wind. Then we have Kapha horse, mucus, it's like earth and water. So there is a lot of everything. So these heart shaped butts and a lot of mane and a lot of tail and big hooves, big heads also. So that will be a Kapha shape of a horse. And we know it corresponds with the Kapha mind. These horses are generally slow, relaxed, nothing spooks them. They are reliable, confident. So we know that it commonly corresponds. And in Pitta type of horses, they're somewhere in the middle. It's a fire. So they are quite like average built, not skinny and not like heart-shaped butts either. That's a typical horses for show jumping, dressage, and various kind of competitions, because they are reliable. They have the drive for competing. They like to show themselves and they can handle some pressure. And Kapha horse also can handle pressure, but is not sensitive enough to respond to the stimuli. So the Pitta type of horses are generally good horses for competition. So now that you know what's your horse, what's his mind, so how to approach them, what to do with these informations. So I'm sure that's this part that you are looking forward to the most. And I will start with saying, choose what you have and help your horse to be balanced. So this is really important. When I know what I have, it's also important to choose what I have and don't try to change my horse. If I will help the horse to be balanced or naturally in due course of time, the horse might change. And so maybe in 10 years from now, I will have something else, or maybe in 6 months from now, I will have something else, because it's dynamic, as we said. And at the same time, here and now, choose what I have, because it's not going to work to want to have Vata type of horse from Kapha type of horse. So I have a certain personality of the horse right now, it might change. And then how to help the horse to be balanced, and That's the key question. How to help him build his strengths and how to help him balance his weaknesses. So we will get to that for each kind of the dosha. And we will start with Vata. And to understand it better, here we have like listed some increasing factors. What will increase the Vata in the horse? Because, okay, let's say I have a Vata Achelteke type of horse. So he might be balanced and he might be imbalanced. So if the horse is balanced, then I can act according to his psychophysical nature so he doesn't get into imbalance. But it's not absolutely necessary. When the horse is already imbalanced, it's absolutely necessary that I respect his psychophysical nature, I respect his Vata type, and I work with what I have, I'm choosing what I have. Otherwise, I will create disease or co-create disease, and I will co-create a horse that will be really dangerous to be ridden, and it will not be fun, and it will all go down quickly. So when I have a Vata horse that's balanced, I have a super sensitive, gentle, kind friend who is responding to my thoughts. These horses are so sensitive and fine-tuned that, like the riders often say, like, I just think of what I want the horse to do and the horse does it. That's Vata type of horse, very sensitive, submissive. They really like to do for you. And they are very, very fine. They are very fine horses. If they are imbalanced, they are nervous, they are spooky, they are afraid, they cannot focus, they are very distracted. And so the factors, the Vata type is wind, so it's like a wind. And then everything that's increasing is like having similar qualities as a wind. So the wind is always changing. So if there is traveling, changes in life, that I put the horse into different herd or a different stable or a different diet or different show, different country. So that's increasing Vata, wind, because that's the nature of the wind is to change, and I'm adding to this nature more. Also all sorts of stress factors. Wind is light, so if I give the horse only poor diet, then he will become even lighter, like straw and hay. The horse really likes to have some soaked with hot water and with oil to their meals. That's like grounding for them. And it's grounding for the mind, grounding for the body. If there is some tragedy, the horse usually is very attached to their person. Unlike other types of horses, this horse is attached to their person. So if something happens to the person, the horse is like really difficult for him to contend it. If I put too much work on the horse, because they kind of like to, they like to be good. And if I abuse it, if I put too much work on them, the Vata will increase. And of course, if the weather is cold, windy or dry, that will enhance Vata. So what will decrease Vata as riding tools is creating routine, because that routine is so unlike wind. So I create routine. I put some exercises that the horse really knows with confidence and can repeat them again and again and be praised gently, like patting on their neck. They will not like, oh, you are such a good boy. That's a good praise for Kapha type of horse, but not for Vata type of horse. So patting gently, saying, oh, you are such a good boy, with a gentle, loving voice, and creating a lot of success for this horse in the routine work. So we can kind of expect what's next. And if I have a balanced Vata horse, then I can stretch the comfort zone by adding something that's unexpectable for the horse. But if I have already imbalanced Vata horse and putting something that creates more stress, more change, then the Vata will increase even higher, and it's not going to be helpful. So if I want to stretch the comfort zone, it must be at the time when the Vata is relatively balanced, not when it's imbalanced. Now we are going to Pitta type of horse. So for Pitta, if they are balanced, they have a good working ethic. They can handle pressure. They have endurance. They have the most endurance. They like to show themselves, as I already said. They are confident. They are dominant. They are like reliable. They have great memory. They learn well. So that's Pitta type of horse. That's why they are so commonly used for different sports, because they are the best trainable horses. If the Pitta is imbalanced, then the horse is angry, aggressive, is bucking, kicking, biting, grinding his teeth, putting his ears back, developing all sorts of like bad habits. So again, it's helpful to know what's increasing Pitta and have in mind that Pitta is fire. So everything that's sharp and hot is increasing the fire, the Pitta inside. So if it's food, like even carrots have this warming tendency, everything that's red or orange, different drugs, for sure, if you have ginger or chili, turmeric, these kind of things, if you put to this horse, it will increase the fire. Also anger and frustration. And if I'm angry with the horse will increase the anger too. If I have too much demand on him or I put him down and don't respect his dominant nature, if the work seems purposeless, as I said, for the Vata type of horse, they like routine and they like knowing what will come next. For the Pitta type of horse, the same kind of work, like going for 10 circles on left hand, that will be boring for them and purposeless. So I can do shoulder in once with the Pitta kind of horse, and it's okay. If I do it twice, maybe third time, they start to be a little like, why am I doing this again? And if you do it fourth or fifth time, the horse starts to be really angry because he doesn't understand why he should do such nonsense again and again. So they need like various stimuli and learning new things and action and also a lot of respect for their personality, and of like let them think that this was their idea, that they wanted to do this exercise. And also sharp noises or colors, like, you know, the red flag for the bull, it works similar for the Pitta kind of horse. So all these things can increase Pitta. And decreased Pitta are cooling things. We want to cool the fire down. So it's like a nice hay diet that the horse is doing a lot of chewing, that's grounding and cooling. They can have some herbs like menthol, mint, and then the work they are doing is really like balanced, like they get a lot of praise. I don't push them to do again and again one thing, and I'm creative. Kapha horses. Kapha horses are amazing. I would not want to have one, but they are amazing. They are like, you can picture the Budweiser horse. It's earth, a lot of material there, a lot of material. And also it's like super grounding. These horses are best horses for hypotherapy, equine assisted therapy. They like allow you to do anything to them. They will not get spooky or offended or aggressive. They are just like really quiet, grounded, reliable, good friends, sweet. Like they will not push you with their nose like this. Really, like you can put a little child on them or someone disabled for therapy, and they will take care. If they are imbalanced, they are lazy and almost apathetic, like depressed, and it's really not good for their health. Like, okay, like it's not like dangerous or terrible if the horse is like lazy. And if I don't have any like goals to achieve with the horse, it doesn't really matter. Well, yes, it does matter, because the health of a Kapha horse who is not moving is going down quickly. Like, you know, the fat ponies and fat horses who have like so many health problems. So that's the Kapha imbalance. So what we need to do for the Kapha horse is get them moving, give them stimulants, and get the activity out of them. So what increases Kapha is sweets, treats, not enough activity, of course, also cold and humid weather, and eating too much, not enough nutrition. That's a very important point, because we have a tendency the horse is fat. So let's just feed him something that's there is no nutrition. The idea is, so the stomach is full, the horse doesn't feel hungry, and at the same time, there is no nutrition, so he doesn't gain weight. So actually, this idea is only creating that the metabolism goes even slower and the Kapha increases. So what we need to do is to feed like ideally small amounts of food several times a day and add the nutrition. And also add things like ginger, chili, turmeric that will fire the digestion up, that will increase the metabolism and get the horse moving. And the stimulus for the getting the horse moving must be quite like sharp, like come on, like things that the Bata type of horse would fell apart, but the Kapha type of horse generally are not enough. And give them enough time to warm up. They really need time for their slow metabolism to warm up, but they need to move. And especially if there is like cold weather, like try to warm them up from inside by soaking the food with hot water or the ginger or even a sheet, even though it's like contradictory looking at the chubby horse to give him sheet, but that's what forces them to gain more weight. If they are in cold, to put on more weight. That's the natural protection against the cold. So it's increasing kapha. Now we have some summary of what I have just said. So what we can do to balance different horses out is taking care for their meals, for the environment as far as like temperature. How do we train them? There is influence of music and colors. For example, for the Vata type of horse, it might be nice some like background, like soft meditative music. And for Kapha type of horse, like going, colors, influence of the rider. So that's an interesting one, which we will not go through today too much, but you understand that the rider have a big influence on the horse because we have our own psychophysical natures and our own emotions and our own stuff that we put on the horse, and we influence the horse, of course, and the horse influences us, to put like a little view in the direction. So imagine like a Kapha person and a Kapha horse. So that will be like a satisfied pair, Kapha Kapha. So they will not do much together. It will be maybe like a rider sitting on the horse and having a mobile phone in one hand and a cup of coffee in the second hand, and the horse is standing there and the rider is quite satisfied. If you have Pitta horse and Pitta rider, then there will be a lot of sparkling energy between them, because they like bring the different triggers and anger up in each other. We have a Vata horse and a Vata rider. There might be a lot of fear and insecurity, and the rider will be afraid of the horse, and the horse will be afraid of the rider. And of course, for each scenario, there are balanced stages and imbalanced stages, and there is a lot more I could say about that. And I might next time, but I am not promising that. And I thank you very much for your attention. And I hope that you like this video. It was my first video ever. And I had a lot of fun talking to you. And please do not forget to like this, share it if you like it, comment, donate, or also you can have a private session with me where I can help you to find out more about your horse and yourself and the dynamic between you and how to balance it out. So thank you very much again for your attention. I really hope you had fun and that I will see you another time in my next videos. Thank you.